So, the kit contents, what do you get? Well, you get the instruction sheet, which is very clear and takes you through each bit stage by stage. You get the kit map, so it clearly explains what each labelled numbered part is. So as you can see on the instructions with the letters, like say here for part A, it's clearly numbered. And basically you get three sheets. So you get that with the engraved pieces here, so these will basically sit on top of the arch, and these on the girder joints, and as a lovely sort of 3D sort of textured look and feel to it. It's quite amazing what that laser cutter that they use does. So again, this is just held on with some very tiny pips, and it's a case of just using the trusty old craft knife to carefully cut them out. You have the bridge deck, so as you can see on here, that's where one track would sit, and on there, that's where the other track would sit. That's the cross piece that will sit at the top of the arch, and these are the cross members that will sit at various points over the arch to separate and strengthen up the two sides. And the last part of the sheet is the actual bowstring itself, and with the bridge deck sides there. And again, like the other two sheets, it's just a case of carefully cutting the pips out. Now, looking at the thickness of this, you can see here there's a good bit of weight to this. It feels very, very solid, so it has to be, because of the weight it's got to take when your locomotives and trains run across here. So we'll now move on to doing the build of this kit. So now we've cut out basically the three main parts of the bridge. It's case then just gently filing along the edge just to remove the retaining pips that held it in on the fret. And same again on that end there, and basically on the top of the arch there, and these three points here. So how this bit now fits together is that if you look on the bridge deck base here, you'll see these square pegs, and these will fit in the holes along the bottom of the bowstring here. So it's a case of running a bead of glue along there and then inserting. So I'll crack on and do that next, and then we'll show you what you do on the next stage. So we've now got one side of the bowstring fitted in place and glued, and that's really nice. So according to the instructions now, is that we have to take this piece and these four cross pieces and insert them into these holes on the top here. So what I'll do now is to remove these off the fret, and we'll glue and fit them on there, and then we'll come back on the next clip and we'll show you what you do next. So now we've cut out that piece and the remaining four pieces, and these, as I said previously, we're now fitting these holes. So we've also again just filed flush the fret pips, and now we'll just do a test fit. Goes in there lovely. So what we'll do now is we'll just add a little bit of glue. And it is there, don't need much. And we'll insert into the holes. Make sure it's nice and square. And the excess glue, I just use an old cloth just to wipe away. So there you can see now the top central piece is in. On the subject of glue, scalemodelscenery.co.uk recommends using the Deluxe Materials Superphatic glue, but I'm using this Rocket card glue, again by the same company, Deluxe Materials, and apparently this is suitable for card, wood and plastic, so it seems to be working fine, okay, on this. So if you do buy this kit, yeah, one of them two glues should be absolutely fine. Right, we'll now move on and we'll get the rest of these pieces in, and we'll then get the other side on. So as you can see here, we now have the five pieces glued in on this side. Now, one thing you need to make note of is that with these cross pieces, with this end here, has to be the same as them, so it allows for the clearance for your trains on underneath. So what I'll do now is get this set up for the other side of the bowstring bridge to sit on top, and then it's a case again of running a bead of glue on each of these bits here. So we'll move on to that next. So as you can see, we've now got the other side glued on, and it's quite a lightweight, very rigid, strong structure. So the next part now for this is to now cut out this part and the two pieces there, and these are going to go along the bottom and on the arch of the bowstring. So we've now cut out off the fret the next four bits, one being this bottom piece and the other being the bow of the arch. So first of all, we'll just do a test fit to make sure all goes well. Yeah, that looks good to me. And then again, the bottom piece. So this piece here is to line up, push me that across, with the corner piece there. So you can see the effect we're going for here. So I'll get these now glued on and we shall move on to the next stage. So as you can see, we've now got the four side pieces on. And the next job we've got to do now is on the fine etched parts here, is that we cut these out, and these long pieces, they're the rivet detail that sits on top of the arch of the bowstring, and these rivet plates here, these will sit on each one of these at the bottom. So I'll now get these cut out and stuck on, and you can see what the kit looks like when it's finished. So as you can see in front of you now, we finished the kit. We got the last of the rivet plates that go across the girder joints. So the glue is just basically now sitting on there. So as you can see, that is for one track on that bit there, and on this section here is for your second track. So once the glue's set, it's just a case of painting it. So I'm going to use this Halfords grey primer spray paint, like what I used on the communications mast kit, which I showed you in one of the previous videos. And now I've got to make the second bridge up, which will be adding on at this end, and then it's a case of doing the end support, the bridge abutment, which will go against the wall up on the layout there. And as I speak, Scale Model Scenery are looking at doing some support pillar legs to basically go with this kit or any other bridge. So once that kit's out, we'll do a video on that. Thanks for watching.